Hello, this is Abram Pelch with Laptop Magazine, and we're here today with the Dell Inspiron Duo, Dell's first convertible netbook, otherwise known as a netvertible in industry jargon. Obviously, this is a 10.1-inch netbook, but it's got a really unique feature where it can flip around and become a tablet. Before I flip this the whole way and get into tablet mode, let me just talk to you a little bit about its hardware here. You've obviously got your nice island-style keyboard here, which is pretty comfortable for typing. You've got your touchpad. Interesting little note here with the touchpad buttons. We love that it has discrete buttons. We hate the single button, bar button. We're not big fans of that. But because the buttons actually aren't on the edge here or close to it, I've already had a couple instances where I tried to click it and I ended up clicking this. That's, you know, some minor little annoyance, but something to take a note of. Just to take a quick look at this closed, this has a Atom dual core N550 CPU running at 1.5 gigahertz, 2 gigs of RAM, Windows 7 Home Premium, it says on Dell's website a 320 gigabyte hard drive, but this is a pre-production unit with a 250 gigabyte slower 5400 RPM hard drive, unlike the 7200 that they have listed on the site. So here, on the side here, you can see that the ports are underneath this paneling here. You've got a couple USB ports here, and you've got your audio. And this is a very nice rubberized material all around. This unit here is gray, but it also comes in a much more attractive blue and red color. But the one that we got sent here is the gray. If you take a look back at the lid, it's got the Dell logo and it's got this kind of wallpaper pattern. This is glossy, but the area around it is not. And finally, let's just take a quick look at the bottom, which also has kind of this rubberized soft touch feel. You know, we wish everything was made out of this kind of material. Now let's just have a quick look at the main feature. So obviously, when you're like this, you're in Windows 7 Home Premium, you can type. It's a perfectly normal netbook, although the touchscreen does, which is a capacitive multi-touch touchscreen that supports two-finger gestures, does work like this. But most people don't want to use their touchscreen when they're in clamshell mode. What they want to do is flip this baby around like so, close it up, and what do we have here but our touchscreen. Now what you'll notice that's really, really interesting is it knows that you flip the screen around and it launches the Dell Inspiron Duo software here, which gives you these nice finger-friendly shortcuts that are a lot easier to tap on than you normally experience with Windows 7. Now on this unit here, which is a pre-production unit, we were playing with these. Let's just take a quick look. Here's the music one. And what we noticed on our pre-production unit, which has a 5400 RPM hard drive, is things were a little slow to load. But we're hoping when we see the final unit with a 7200 RPM hard drive, it'll be a bit faster, because you can see that actually is taking quite a while. But here we have the music software. You can tap on an artist and wait a couple seconds, and you'll see the artist's screen come up. Just make sure that was tapped. And what we found is, you can see, if you saw the Windows little wheel spinning there, the software, at least on this pre-production build, has been a little bit slow to load things and to react. You can see it's sort of giving us some indication of what we want. Now it's playing, and you can kind of go around here and choose different artists. You can go into a library. It has Napster support here, and you know, you have this bar down here for controlling the volume. Much more touch-friendly than just the Windows bar here. You can stop. So that's the music app. You tap the little X there, and we'll check out the photo app. Again, it's taking a few seconds to load here. But you can see, here are some sample photos. They look pretty good. It also supports multi-touch gestures, so you can pinch to zoom in or out. That's the photo gallery. Actually, we just exited the Dell Inspiron UI layer, and we're back at the Windows desktop, which we didn't mean to do. That can happen because the X is in the same corner. Let's take a look here at videos. This is a video player that's more touch-friendly, but you can also see this is taking a second. It's called Video Stage. And there's a sample video in here. Again, you can see that it's taking several seconds to get to where it's going. We think that's just the pre-production stuff going on. Here you can actually buy movies from the store. Here's a sample video that will tap on here. You see it starts loading. This is a wildlife video. This is sort of a little information about it, and I have to tap the player here to get it going. Think. See, it can be a little bit frustrating. So, right now on this pre-production unit, getting the things up can be a little slow to load. But we anticipate that when we see the final unit later, it will be faster. But the UI itself, and once it starts playing the video, it's really, really good for finger. Well, let's get out of this. We've kind of seen it working. And again, I accidentally closed the wrong window. And you can see while I'm still doing this, the Windows taskbar is down here. And what I have to do here actually to stop it is I have to tap on the video, and then I have to get this little X. But back to the UI layer, there's a books one. I'll just take a quick look at that. What all this does actually is it launches a Dell bookstore, but it's just, you can see it's actually launched it in Internet Explorer. So no special interface here, not even a special X to close Internet Explorer. It's just plain old Internet Explorer. Same thing if you tap Internet, it just launches Internet Explorer for you, not even with any bigger buttons. And Paint here launches a little drawing program, which is kind of neat. We'll take a quick look at that once that loads. The games app, by the way, we won't show you because all that does is actually open the games folder in your start menu. It doesn't actually have any special touch games. So you can see here we've got this little drawing program, which is kind of neat. You can pick a little pen here. It'll roll you out a palette of colors, and you can start drawing. And the drawing's not bad. It's pretty much keeping up with our finger. It's not like you can see where it's not able to really simultaneously do. I guess this program doesn't support multi-touch, even though the hardware does, because I'm not able to draw in two directions at once. But it's a nice little program. And as you may know, there are a lot of drawing programs out there that you can download, like ArtRage, so you're not stuck with the programs that come on this, because it's giving you really the flexibility of Windows 7. So, we'll show you in a minute the docking station that you can get with this, but let me flip this back. And by the way, before I do that, I want to show you also that it will adjust. It has an accelerometer in it, and it will actually turn into portrait mode. So that's kind of neat. did find it was a little slow to react, and of course it does turn the screen black for a second, which is, I guess, a Windows thing because we've seen that in other Windows tablets. So that is the Dell Inspiron Duo. Right now it's starting at about $550 on Dell's site. And for a dual-core netbook, you know, that also gives you this multi-touch feature, that's a very interesting and not too expensive pricing, because you get this netbook, this powerful netbook with a high-res screen, and then you also can turn it into a tablet. So this is Avram Pilch with Laptop Magazine, and we're here with the Dell Inspiron Duo.